Hello everyone, welcome back to Pharma E-Class. I am Aminda Goswami from Smriti College of Pharmaceutical Education, and in this online lecture series we were discussing about drying as a part of pharmaceutical engineering for B.Pharm third semester students. In the previous classes we had conceptualized and we have studied about the different aspects of the theoretical aspects of drying, its basic requirements, its need and the theories behind the drying process. As we know, the application of every theory in this subject is in the machines, in the different types of which applications are in this case it is dryers. So in this lecture we will discuss about the different types of dryers. Dryers are the machines in which the pharmaceutical operation is being of drying is being performed. So we will discuss about the classification and the description of different types of dryers. So let us come to the basic recap. Yes, you have already know it is the drying is the process of removal of a liquid from a particular solid by the means of thermal methods, and it is most common in the pharmaceutical industries in the preparation of granules which can be packed in bulk or compressed into tablets or filled into capsules. Now the dry products are often most stable. Yes, moisture, we have already studied, as you already know, moistures can be reasons of different problems. So we want to eliminate the moisture, so we have to go through the process of drying. So dry products are more stable than moist ones, as in the case of effervescent salts, maybe of aspirin, maybe of different hygroscopic powders like ascorbic acids, penicillins, and it is used to reduce the bulk weight that lowers the transportation cost, so it improves also the material handling. Next, how we choose the method of drying, because there are different methods, and obviously as necessity is the mother of invention, so the choice of the dryers or the drying method also depends on these points. We have to check whether the product is heat sensitive or not. The sample from which we have to make the loss of moisture, definitely we have to eliminate the moisture with the help of thermal methods, but the product is heat sensitive or not. So in the entire machine, what will be the condition of the product in that hot atmosphere? So that is an important point. Next is nature of the solvent is to remove. What is the nature of the solvent? Is the solvent volatile or is the solvent a regular solvent? What is the nature of the solvent? That is also important. The process, either it needs to be carried out in aseptic condition. So we need to do the process in entirely a aseptic condition where there should be zero contamination of any other things. So that aseptic condition is needed or not. In that case, the dryer, the process has to be changed a little bit. We have to validate the process again. The quantity of the products to be dried. What is the bulk size of the product that is we need to dry up? The available sources of heat. What are the different sources of heat? What are the available sources of heat that we need, that we have to apply into the dryer? And obviously our budget or the cost involved. So these are the different choice of methods which is opted for drying and for dryers. Yes, this is the classification of different types of dryers. First we'll study classification which is based on the solid handling. How the solid is being the feed, the material from which we have to eliminate the moisture that is to be handled. In industry terms, we have to call it as feed. Feed implies the material from which we have to eliminate the moisture or the material or the wet mass. That is called as feed. Or the solid handling, how we have to handle the solid. So there are basically two basic classification: the material when it is agitated, or material which is not agitated, sorry, and it is agitated. Material not agitated, that means we have to make the drying material a stagnant one or a static one, and when material is entire material, we can move the entire material or material base. So material not agitated, static bread dryers. By static we mean the material is fixed in a particular tray or a trough. That is static bread dryers. In the static bread dryer also we have two types of classification, like batch process and the continuous type. Batch process implies we have to do the process by one a single batch. And continuous process includes we have to go on adding the feed, we have to run the machine, we have to make it workable, and constantly up to a certain time period the process will go on. So that is the difference between a batch process and a continuous process. In the batch type of dryers, batch type of static bed dryers, where the material, the feed is not agitated, the material is not stirred or it is not done anything, it is fixed. Then we have batch type, that is tray and truck dryers, we have vacuum shelf dryers, we have freeze dryers, where material is static, material bed is not agitated, and we can do it in a batch wise. Whereas we can, in the same classification, we can move as a continuous type, where we can go on adding the feed and continuously the drying process will go on occurring. So we have tunnel type of dryers, we have belt dryers, we have festoon dryers, and we have drum dryers. So material not agitated, static bed dryers, batch type, continuous type. This is the batch type of dryers of static bed one, and this is the continuous type of dryers of the static bed one again. Next, when we are moving the material, when the material is agitated, then we have moving bed dryer and fluidized bed dryer. In the moving bed dryer, again we have two basic types, that is batch type and continuous type. The batch type includes vacuum tumble dryers and tan dryers, whereas continuous type includes the rotary dryers, the turbo tray dryers, vibrating conveyor dryers, tower and cascade dryers, screw conveyor dryers. Whereas the fluidized bed dryer, these are entirely different state we will study. Fluidized bed dryer, where the material is being handled like a fluid. Material is handled like a fluid and that material is being agitated in the fluidized state. So in the fluidized bed dryer, we have again the vertical type of dryer, which is the batch type of fluidized bed dryer, and the continuous type, we have the horizontal vibrating conveyor dryers and the vertical dryers, which is the continuous type of fluidized bed dryers. Next, in case of pneumatic dryers, we have the continuous type only, we have the spray dryers and the flash dryer. That is entirely a different process, where only we want to solidify or we want to dry liquid products. That is in case of the spray dryers, which we will study later on. So this is the process of the classification of dryers based on methods of solid handling. Next, there is another type of classification which depends on the heat transfer mechanism. As you must be knowing, in your physics class you have studied, there are three basic types of heat transfer mechanisms, like conduction, convection and radiation. So based on these three principles, we have the different types of dryers that is used in industry. In terms of convection dryers, we have tray or shelf dryers, we have tunnel dryers, we have rotary dryers, and we have fluidized bed dryers. So same dryers, the examples are almost same, the names are familiar with the previous type of classification, but here the heat transfer mechanism is something different. Next, we have conduction type of dryers, where we have the vacuum oven or the vacuum dryers, and we have the freeze dryers. And next, we have the radiation type of heating mechanism dryer, that is the IR or the infrared type of dryers. So it depends, that because you must be knowing, drying is a process of heat transfer as well as mass transfer. So based on the heat transfer mechanism, drying is classified, dryers are classified like this. So we have studied in the previous slides about the basic classification of different types of dryers depending on the heat transfer mechanism, as well as the depending on the materials, which how it is agitated or it is not agitated or it is being static. So this is our first machine which we can find routinely in different pharmaceutical industries. It is called as tray dryers, truck dryers, shelf dryers, cabinet dryers, compartment dryers. The same machine, different names, a little bit variation in the designs, and also this can be used in for different purposes also. So construction, yes, this is the basic construction of a tray or a truck dryer. When this tray dryer can be used as a truck dryer, when there will be some wheels. So without these wheels for movement, for transportation purpose, and without this wheel, this is a fixed type of dryer. It is a fixed type of dryer where we have this type. This is the basic construction Construction consists of a small cabinet or large compartment in which trays containing wet materials are placed. So these are the shelves in which we have to place the heated material. Okay, so the compartment wall is insulated to reduce heat loss. The materials which is fed inside the trays, when hot air is being circulated, we must ensure hot air does its job of the vaporization of the moisture. For that purpose, this all the side walls are properly insulated so that there is no heat loss. In the tray dryers, the trays are directly placed inside the cabinet. Yes, we can place inside the shelves the trays, we can directly place it. Next, the material is heated by hot air which is circulated by means of fans, and there are also some exhaust fans from which we can dehumidify the air, or we can eliminate the humid air which is inside. So there are heating coils like this. So this is the air outlet, these are the shelves. So fresh air comes from this direction and it goes through the heater and it is heated up. Then with the help of this fan, it is circulated throughout the different sample, wet mass which I have kept in the trays. And heat air is circulated, and if there is any humid airs, that can be eliminated by the help of this air outlet with the help of an exhaust fan. So energy source, dryer can be heated either by electricity or by steam. There are options so that the heat energy can also be generated by steam also. What are the applications of the tray dryer or truck dryers? Drying of crude drugs, chemicals, powders, some tablet granules, they can also be done in this type of dryer. I have routinely followed one. It is a batch process and material can be handled separately. Yes, we cannot go on continuously adding the material because it is the dryer which is made up of suitable for the batch process. Now come to its application. So this is the image of an ideal industrial tray dryer which we will find in the PG Pharmaceutics laboratory of our institute. So these are the different shelves, and in those shelves there are trays, these are steel trays in which we can put the sample, the wet sample, wet mass, and we will have to close it, we have to switch on the machine, and hot air will be circulated throughout, and from time to time we'll take out the sample, we'll weigh the sample, and we'll check what is the moisture content happening in that particular sample. So this is a very basic design of a tray dryer. This simple tray or cabinet dryer can be improvised with new designs in the form of a truck dryer, where we can impart some wheels and it will be made as a movable device. This is another example of a continuous type of dryer, but a static bed one, that is drum dryers. So this is the basic construction. I'm coming to the construction. So in drum dryers, a liquid containing dissolved solids or a slurry carrying a suspended solid forms a thin layer on this particular drum. So this is a drum which is rotating. Just see, this is the direction of rotation, and this is the liquid slurry feed. The feed is kept in a trough inside, and we can feed the slurry continuously. So when this drum is rotating, at the same time we can impart hot air in that atmosphere. So while rotating in that particular thing, in that particular slurry, in this fashion it is rotating, so it will come down, it will take the slurry, then it will go up. With the help of the spreader, we can spread that solution also. So a thin film of the slurry will be present over the drum. So when that slurry will be dried, that dried slurry will be cut off in the form of dried material with a scraper knife. So in drum dryers, a liquid containing a dissolved solids or slurry carrying suspended solids form a thin layer on the outside surface of a large rotating drum. A gas, normally air, be blown out over the surface for rapid removal of moisture. The rotation of the drum is adjusted so that the liquid is fully vaporized. This rotation can be adjusted, we can control that rotation, and that can be liquid is fully vaporized, and a dry deposit can be scraped off with the help of a flexible or adjustable knife. So here a flexible or adjustable knife is being kept. The speed of the drum can be regulated by means of a variable speed drive to adapt the speed to any slight variation of the feed quality. So this is a very basic construction of the drum dryer. Come to its advantages and disadvantages. Yes, coming to the advantages. This is a quick method because of its large surface area. Because of the large surface area, constantly we can go on drying the material. Instrument is a compact one, so it requires a small space for the operation. The equipment can be enclosed in a vacuum chamber. Yes, this which we had saw, that was a basic design, but it could be enclosed in a vacuum chamber, so we can maintain that particular temperature which we need. What are the disadvantages? Yes, the operation conditions are critical because we have to make it to say the three operations continuously. The drying operation, the spreading operation, as well as the scrapping operation. So it is a critical sort of instrument machine. Now the feed control and the necessity, there are certain points which has to be considered to introduce the careful control on the feed rate, temperature of the drum, the thickness of the film, the speed of the rotation of the drum. These are the points which we have to be considered during the operation of the drum dry. So this is the diagram or an image of a particular industrial drum dryer.